What's up, everybody? It's Bodyhead Productions here, and today we're talking about Rainbow Six Vegas. So, as far as the story mode goes, you have to play it yourself. I thought that is not where the game shines, but it's more in the pros and cons of player customization, weapon choices, terrorist hunts, the maps, and the insanely fun online multiplayer. So, let's start off with the customization. Protection and mobility. Two words that will decide what the hell your guy looks like and if he's going to get caught lacking. If you're too slow, regardless of the cover system, your peak shots will be affected, and closing gaps or flanking becomes a harder task. You can take your guy out, is what I'm saying, but he will be slower than a one-legged turtle. No turtles were offended in this, and there is no anti-turtleism to this joke. Anyway, more protection or tanking will make a huge difference in your ability to handle one-shot kills. For example, a close-range shotgun, an enemy getting first shot at you from behind, etc. These things where you would normally lose these situations, more protection will give you a better chance of surviving them. And the way you increase this comes in cosmetic forms of heavy bulletproof vests, pads for your legs, larger helmets. So basically, if you go all in on protection, your guy will look like the two armored covered robbers famous from this scene right here. And then we get to mobility. The speed at which your player can move makes a huge difference when it comes to getting around. I mean, well, obviously, but let's explain it a little more. For example, on the Las Vegas casino map, a player that could rappel the opposite side of the roof with all mobility would be in place to kill before anyone expected. What do I mean by this? When the game first came out, players would stay upside down on a rope rappel with just a pistol and kill players. But the thing was, this was so unexpected because they would get there within about 12 seconds of the match starting. Like, how the hell did you get there, son? No one's expecting you to be there already. No one can really shoot you from that angle. And you get a great element of surprise because no one expects you to be there because you got there so fast. You moved so quickly, it's not normal. Most players go for an even hatch between the two, protection and mobility. Now, these two choices are interesting because of the health system in Rainbow Six. You can be one-shotted, oftentimes somewhat easy depending on the weapon, but the health regen system works similar to Call of Duty or a Gears of War game. Hide out after being shot for a bit and you'll heal. Stay in combat and you keep getting shot, your entire screen will gradually turn more and more black until you die and it's completely black. And that's the X factor. That's how the health regen is different than those other games. The screen turns completely black as you are shot, so sometimes you'll be very close to death with a chance to get away, but the darker than Crayola crayon black screen will make it harder to escape. And this is great because it rewards smart plays, pushes, and angles. You can't just go running through the map repeatedly because your TV will go blind and you will die over and over and over. And this is where the tactical part comes in. It's not quite Call of Duty, it's a slowed down, more concentrated pace. And it's a little better than Gears of War because it's not as forgiving. And this applies to pretty much every part of the game. I'm not including the story here, but it most definitely applies to the terrorist hunts as well. One of my personal favorite parts of the game. Your mobility and movement have just as much of an effect here. And this is one of the greatest things I remember about Rainbow Six. Was the enemy AI in these terrorist hunts. It was challenging. They were smart. They would move and react to sounds, explosions, dead bodies in a realistic manner. Whether it's how they would stack a room on all different sides, or if you're camping in a hallway, more than likely one would end up behind you from a different route and blast you to pieces. And just like your playable character, the rules to the terrorist hunts were customizable as well, with different difficulties and population sizes. For example, the LVU campus map with a high-density, realistic AI was the absolute best, because there would also be a set of bells on the campus you could shoot, and loads of enemies would hear that and they would come to it, but only the ones in that immediate area. And then you could just turn it into a firing yard, taking these guys out. But the more you get those guys to move, it's like the AIs are talking to each other, guys on the other side of the map will rotate as well, but they won't come to that bell. They'll wait in positions for where you might come leaving that bell. Now, most maps didn't have this type of bell or something similar to that, and it made entry into every room, hallway, corridor very exciting. In addition to door entries, there would be an option for opening and throwing a flashbang, a smoke, or a grenade as well. And with the ability of night vision and heat vision, this gave for many different styles of play. Rainbow Six was always a very tactical game, and this was my first experience with a game of that genre. Team up with a friend and do a terrorist hunt, it really felt like you two against the world on that map. Speaking of the map selection is fantastic. All of them based around casinos, vaults, streets in Las Vegas, or places like the LVU campus. There are so many different levels to these maps because they're so damn big, too. Between the attics, the basements, the side rooms, vaults, finding the last terrorist or five would become a struggle. As soon as you'd let your guard down after taking out most of them, bam! Then you'd find him, and your whole screen would turn black because you stopped taking cover before you went around every freaking door. What was great, though, is it's not like they'd always just come to you. You would have to go looking for them. And there'd be places you would not want to go with your character. You didn't want to go into that room because you knew you could get shot easy doing so. But the game forced you to do it. It's an objective-based game, and that's what worked so well for these terrorist hunts as well. Now, Rainbow Six Siege is the current Rainbow Six game, and it's quite popular. It's got a great esports scene. It's got a talk show from Veli, former Gears of War, on the flank talk show host. Now he's hosting it for Rainbow Six. But mainly, the game looks to be a great time. However, I, as usual, still seem stuck in the past, as Rainbow Six Las Vegas would always be my favorite. The game has a sequel as well. Check it out, everyone. It's cheap as hell now, and it's backwards compatible on the Xbox One. So the tactical fun awaits. I'm going to throw in a little montage of some of the greatest maps that this game had to offer. And let me know what you guys think of it. I'll catch you guys in the next one. This has been Rainbow Six Vegas.